Hey guys, Jay here with Server Side Up. Just wanted to go through and give you an update. There's been a little bit of radio silence on where things are at, but I promise you that radio silence just means that I've been inside of a code editor before anything else. Looking at what we have here, I just wanted to visualize all the different products that we have going on. Three of these are all open source, and they all kind of stem around this financial freedom product, which is a very interesting thing that Dan started just as a fun project, and it took off faster than we expected. And now we're just taking a step back and reapproaching things and going to use this as a great opportunity to share some of our experience of building Laravel applications, especially from the infrastructure side of things, of running a Laravel application no matter where it's running, if it's in the cloud or if it's on a Raspberry Pi in somebody's home lab in their basement. Financial Freedom is an open source alternative to Mint, You Need a Budget, etc. Just a sneak peek with that. We're working on the designs for it, of where you'll be able to import your transactions and see your spending comparisons. And there's a lot of ideas that we have for this. And our vision is that people should be able to have control over their private data, especially this nature of data. That's very important, especially as our financial times have only increased pressures. So we want people to be able to run this in their home labs, run this in their cloud providers, wherever they want to run it. And we're going to be using Laravel and Vue and Redis and MeleSearch. It's going to be quite a complex app, but we're going to show the delivery of how we do this through a number of our other open source projects. So speaking of which, that moves us on to our other one called Spin. And Spin is a Laravel Sail alternative. Laravel Sail is wonderful, but Spin takes Sail to the next level of not only can you just run it in development, but it will last the entire life cycle of an application. So that's where we get into CI, staging, and production. So Spin is just basically a shortcut of Docker Compose. It improves the user experience. It centralizes all of our configurations within the project, making it even easier when you're transferring from one computer to another. You go to the Apple store, get a new MacBook or something like that. It's literally just as easy as dragging and dropping onto a machine and just running Spin up. And the other take that we're doing too is I have right in front of me a machine that is running Ubuntu, Linux, and Windows. So we're not going to forget our brothers and sisters that are using different platforms. Even with having totally different base operating systems, we're going to be able to replicate everything that you see here with Financial Freedom locally. And then I'm also working on that we have the GitHub code spaces support so that people can even just come to Financial Freedom, press the period key, and everything just fires up and people have a development environment. So lots of flexibility in that. Now, Spin is heavily based off of Docker Compose and Docker Swarm. So when we get to configuring production servers and stuff, I'm writing a bunch of Ansible scripts that people really don't need to understand what Ansible is. Basically, Ansible is just like a really handy script runner, and it's very intelligent in how it executes those scripts for configuring servers. But the user experience of this is just going to be as simple as somebody coming down and just configuring a simple YAML file. So if you can figure out things like this, and even though we have some secrets in here, there will be some encryption supported so that you can just have 100% of your configurations within the project and everybody's literally on the same page because everything's version controlled in Git itself. Now, with running our Financial Freedom app in particular, this is a Laravel app. So providing PHP images is also something that is very important to us. And a lot of people have been following us with this project. It started off very well, but now we're starting to see some growth and some other compatibility challenges. And in this version 3, we're going to be solving all of that. So the way that we would run PHP before is we would base it off of Ubuntu, which is a great operating system. And then we would use this tool called S6 Overlay. An S6 overlay is great for especially weird things like PHP, where it needs to have two processes running. So like PHP, FPM, and Apache, those are two things all in the same container. And it helped us get a single source of truth of how the health of those services are. So the Essex overlay motto is it's going to do one thing very well, and it may have many processes, but as soon as one of those processes fail, the entire container needs to fail. And that was great until we ran into some compatibility issues and some opinions from Essex overlay that prevented it from working in some of the larger hosts and the way that they chose to run their infrastructure. The other thing that we ran into is with Ubuntu 22.04, we pulled everything from the PPA of Andrej PHP, which has been the de facto bulletproof standard of how I would deploy PHP servers for a very long time. The only thing is that we would not be able to pin or request PHP versions based off the minor version or the patch version. It was always based off the minor version. So getting something like 8.2.11 versus 8.2.10 was not possible. We could only just choose 8.2 and it always defaulted to the latest. So with those two things, that's where we took a step back on this. And now rather than trying to create our own way and try to work with things that were pre-Docker days, now we're going to just take our user experience, what we had before, and just provide that on top of the official PHP images. There's major benefits with this. A, we don't have to use S6 overlay on everything. So that's going to increase our compatibility with a ton of hosts. B, when people are using the official PHP images, it gives them a lot greater confidence on switching over to our new images because they're based off the same base layer operating systems and structure. And then the other thing is that we're also going to be able to offer an Alpine version. So before we had just Ubuntu and that was it, we are now going to be switching over to Debian and Alpine, which is what the official PHP repository has. So let's give you a quick demo of the Docker PHP images that we're working on. You can see that everything is formulated to support both the Debian-based systems and Alpine-based systems throughout this image. We've changed a lot of things around of pulling away from the dependency on S6 overlay, where people are able to go into what I call our entry point D folder, and you can add scripts in here in numerical order so that you can control of which execution steps you want to do. And then also I'm going to make it very easy that when people just want to simply disable our scripts, that it's just something as simple as setting an environment variable, which is really nice. Now, looking into the other things that we have going on, this is still a work in progress. We have the different variations, but we will also be providing an Nginx unit variation, which will be very helpful. This will be a total replacement to FPM, and I'm very hopeful that this will be the answer to many of the permission headaches that a lot of people experience with Docker. And it's a more modernized approach of running just any sort of service in a container. Now, looking at what we have here, I just previously did a build. I'm just going to clear this out. Let's bring this guy up. And notice this is a little bit of a preview of Spin. I've done a lot of work on this. I've been using it on my machine. It's a lot more intelligent. Usually Spin would require the two environment files, but we are now supporting things of just some basic things. And then I also improved the caching of things as well, of Spin knowing when to pull the image. It's intelligent on a per product or per project basis, but also very easy for us to just use Spin with Docker Compose and not really feel like we're abandoning the standards that are defined by Docker itself. So we have this online. Let's just take a look. I'm going to refresh this. Let's look at the default time zone. So we have that set to UTC by default, and we're just going to keep all of this set up so that you can easily come in and change around your settings via environment variables, which is nice because you don't have to worry about putting all these stupid configs everywhere. We'll bring this guy down. I'm actually going to speed this one up. Let's kill that container off. Let's come over here. I'm going to bring that back up. Yep, I just want to use that base image there, or that base Docker Compose file. And you can see the default time zone here is set to America, New York, with just something as simple as changing that. So a lot better experience. We're going to keep that. All these are built off of the official PHP images, but you also get the same wonderful experience that we provided before. So looking back at this, lots of things in the tooling to invest into financial freedom. We also have Bug Flow, which is something that Dan and I released, And we intend to use this to build financial freedom in public. So it's nice and easy for us to do all of our testing right here, and it will sync right into our GitHub repository and people can see us using that. This has been an extremely powerful tool, especially for just two people. This is our secret recipe and how we can be so efficient. And then we have another software as a service product that will be coming out real shortly. In the meantime, Dan's adding another book that should be coming out soon in regards to browser extensions. That'll be very helpful because we learned a lot in building bug flow here. And we're just very excited to see all this stuff come together. We're very grateful for all the support that we've had across the world. If you see anything that you want to help contribute on, a lot of these are still like in their concrete foundational steps, but there will definitely be plenty of testing requests coming up for PHP Docker Images and Spin and people just inserting their opinions. I'm very interested to hear on how people get started with that. I've been working on, if I look at the Spin website here, doing like a whole new Spin website, what we did with the Docker PHP images and getting this all documented and making this like a really good resource to for people, no matter where they're running this app, if it's macOS, Windows, Linux, it's a really good experience to just get up and off the ground running with developing your own app. Stay tuned as we kind of have these in a testing state here shortly. Financial freedom, you will start to see a lot more movement here once we have these other products done. Right now, most of the code is just based off of the side project that we set it up as, but we're going to start from the top and work our way through and make sure that we have the app structured in a way where people can easily contribute and add and see us build that in public. So thanks again for all your support. And if you have any questions, feel free to just jump over to serversideup.net and click on the Discord icon. We'd love to have you. We have a lot of great discussion in there, and we'd love to learn from you as well. So anything else, just let us know. Thanks.